Welcome to Yoga on the Road with Melissa. I'm really happy that you've joined me today. In this session, we're coming from the Black Rock Desert in Nevada. As always, you do what you can, skip what doesn't work, and just try to have some fun. So we'll begin on our mats in child's pose, knees as wide as the mat, toes touch, sit back on your heels, forehead rests on the mat, arms long in front of you. Take a deep inhale and a loud sigh. Come into your Ujjayi breathing, in and out of the nose. Maybe rock your head left to right, gentle stretch for your neck. Begin to engage your core, press the hips back and crawl the hands forward, fingers spread wide. Roll up to your hands and your knees. And we'll begin with a few cow cats. So as you inhale, you lift the tail, you lift the shoulders and gaze up. And as you exhale, arch your back, cat. Couple more, inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Three more. Exhale, cat. Two more, inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Last one, inhale. Exhale, cat. And then come to a neutral spine. Arms are long as you press the hands away from you, lifting the left leg straight back, reaching the right arm forward, getting as long as you can. Stay connected to the breath here. Can you lengthen that left arm? Can you get a little longer from the tips of your right fingers to the heel of your left foot? Take one more inhale, exhale, release, and just switch sides. Kick the right leg back, reach the left arm forward. Get as long as you can. At the same time, lengthen that right arm. Keep breathing. One more deep inhale, lengthen. Exhale, release. Curl the toes, press back, downward facing dog. Walk your hands all the way back towards your feet, ragdoll. Relaxing the neck. Maybe you shake the head out, yes and no. Knees can be bent a little or a lot here. And release your hands to the mat. Heel toe your feet a little closer together and then stand. Arms reach up, right hand grabs the left wrist, reach up and go over to the right side. Inhale, exhale, back to center, switch sides, reach up and go over. Inhale, exhale, back to center, interlace your hands behind your back. Heart and gaze go up to the sun, deep inhale. Exhale with a long spine, fold forward all the way down, nose to your knees, arms over your head, stretch it all out. Hands to the mat, and then just walk yourself back to that downward facing dog. Walk it out, keep breathing. And then bring your feet together to touch, lift the right leg, bend the knee, peel it open, circle the ankle, spread the toes. And return that foot to the mat. Left leg lifts, reach it high, bend it, circle and breathe. And return that foot to the mat. Rise to the balls of your feet and rock forward, high push up, press forward, stretch out your wrists. Exhale, press back, down dog. Rise to the balls of the feet, bend the knees, step walk or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, rise. This time, hands shoulder width distance apart, chair, sink it low. And then see if you could lift your heels up off the mat. You're balancing on the balls of your feet. And then see if you can drop the hips a little bit lower. Shoulders are soft, breath is calm. Take one last inhale. Drop your heels, reach your hands behind your back. Interlace and once again, fold nose to your knee. Shake your head out, keep breathing. Release your hands to the mat, halfway lift, and then gently step it back, chaturanga, high to low push-up, upward facing dog and downward facing dog, walking it out. Fingers are spread wide, you're rooted into your hands. Lift the right leg, three-legged dog, and with control, high push-up. Right knee, right elbow, give it a tap and kick it back. High push-up knee into your third eye, kick it back. High push-up knee to the left, tap the elbow and kick it back. Step it through, warrior one. Inhale brings you up. Exhale, you soften. Deep inhale here. Exhale, open it up, warrior two. Sink and lengthen. Flip the front hand, reverse, inhaling. Exhale, extended side angle, forearm rests on the thigh. Press the shoulder and the hip back. Press the right knee open. If you'd like, extend that top arm over your head, or you can wrap that arm around your back, gazing up to the sky. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, go ahead, straighten that front leg. If you have the bind, feel free to keep it. Otherwise, you can release it. Leaning back, opening up. Again, if you want to extend that top arm over your head, feel free. You could lift that bottom arm up or not. Just one inhale. Exhale, frame the front foot. Step the back foot a little closer. Gentle twist, belly over the thigh, nose to the knee. Standing split, lift that left leg, toes point to the sky, drop your head, relax. Just one last inhale. And as you exhale, step the left foot next to the right, inhale, rise, hands touch, excellent job. Swan dive, nose to knees, halfway lift, step it back, chaturanga dandasana, high to low push up, up dog and down dog, walk it out. Calm breathing here, stay connected. Same thing, left side, lift the left leg. Rock forward, high push-up, left knee, left elbow, tap it and kick it back. High push-up, knee into your third eye, kick it back. High push-up, knee to the right, tap the elbow and kick it back. Step that foot between your hands, here we go. Rise up, inhale, warrior one. Exhale, open it up, warrior two, sink and lengthen, inhale. Exhale, flip it and reverse it, sink and reach, open up, inhale. Exhale, extended side angle, pressing the top shoulder and the hip back, pressing the left knee open, feel your hips and your heart opening here. Again, you could extend that top arm over your head, you could take a bind, half or full, whatever works. Gently leaning back, gazing up, allowing the healing rays of the sun to nurture you. Keep breathing. If you have the bind and you want to keep it, feel free. You could go ahead and straighten that right leg. You could reach those arms up to the ceiling, pressing back, opening up, triangle, staying just as you are, or extending that arm over your head, maybe picking up that bottom arm. Lean back, just one last inhale. Exhale, frame the front foot. Step the back foot a little closer. Gentle twist, belly over thigh as you fold, nose to your knee. Feel your left hip pressing back as your right hip presses forward. And then release that right leg, toes point to the ceiling. Standing split. If you want to play with the balance, go ahead, grab the ankle. One hand, two hands, maybe not. One more inhale. And as you exhale, return that foot to the mat. Inhale, rise. Hands touch. Swan dive, nose to knees, halfway lift. Step it back, chaturanga dandasana. High to low push up, upward facing dog and downward facing dog. Walk it out. And drop to your knees. Come on down to your forearms. Straighten your legs. And today we're going to come over to our right side for a forearm side plank, hand to your hip. And we're going to do those hip lifts. So try to keep your shoulders and your hips stacked in one line. Lift the hips up as high as you can and then lower them as low as you can. We'll do 10 of these. Lift and lower. That's one, two, keep breathing. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. You got it. Come back to center. Low plank. We'll hold it. You can drop your knees if you'd like. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. We switch sides. over to the left, stacking the hips and the shoulders, lift the hips high and then lower, lift and lower. That's one, two, three, keep going, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, back to center, low plank, yes you can, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, long arms, high plank, yes you can, press the heels back, lengthen the arms, calm breathing, you got this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 more because you're strong, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, press it back, excellent job, walk it out. Bring your feet together to touch and lift the right leg. Look at the space between your hands and step that foot between your hands. So this time we do a high lunge. All 10 toes point straight ahead. Take your time, set it up. Widen your feet if you feel a little wobbly. Core's engaged. Let's sigh. Take a deep inhale. Soft, relaxed, confident. You got this. Now, when you're ready, reach the right arm back, left arm forward, thumbs up, pinkies down. Pull your shoulders slightly back so they're stacked over the hips. And only if it feels okay in your body, turn your gaze to your back thumb. Sink deeper, gentle twisting here. Drop the right hand to touch the back thigh. Reach the left fingers up to the sky, sink deeper. And then bring your hands together to touch over your head. Pull it through, touch your third eye in your heart, and then fold forward. Bring the left hand to the mat and reach the right arm up to the sky, gently twisting, pressing that right shoulder back. Keep breathing. And then bring the right hand to the mat, flatten that back foot, straighten your right leg and reach up, triangle pose again. You can keep your fingertips on the mat. You could grab your shin or your ankle. Lean back. Feel your body opening. Feel the resistance and the tension in your hips and in your shoulders just slowly melting away. Keep breathing. If you'd like, extend that top arm over your head. If you'd like, go ahead. Try it again. Pick that bottom arm up. Lean back. You got this. Just one more inhale. And as you exhale, come around into a straddle. So the toes point to the side of the mat, the feet are parallel. Give yourself a halfway lift here to lengthen your spine. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, fold. Allow the neck to soften, head shakes out. Right. And you have options here. You could grab the ankles, the heels. You could pull the belly in towards the right thigh. Third eye to your knee. Gently stretching out and then walking over to the left. Can you hear the Ujjayi breathing? Make sure you're breathing mindfully. Excellent, and then come back to center. And then we're just gonna switch sides. So point the left toes to the left, come on to the ball of the back foot, bend into that left knee, here we go. Take your time, set it up, there's no rush. Find your balance, sinking into that back right heel. Another side to soften and relax us. Take a deep inhale. And again, we're gonna twist. Left arm back, right arm forward. Pressing the left shoulder back. Maybe the gaze turns to the back thumb, and maybe it doesn't, and that's completely okay. Keep breathing. Drop that back hand, touch the back thigh. Reach the right fingers to the ceiling, to the sky. Sink deeper and reach higher. Here we go, hands touch overhead. Pull it through, third eye into your heart. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, we come forward, right hand to the mat. Left arm reaches up, right? So your hips stay parallel. You're twisting from the upper spine. Maybe the gaze turns up to your left hand. Maybe it doesn't. Keep breathing. Excellent. Bring that left hand to the mat. Flatten your back foot. Straighten the left leg and reach your right arm up, coming into that triangle. Hand can rest on the shin or the ankle, or maybe it just hovers. Again, you're leaning back, right? Allowing that resistance that you hold in your hips and in your shoulders to melt. Just just like a snowball in the desert. If you'd like, extend that top arm over your head. If you'd like, lift that bottom arm up, lean back, you got this. Deep inhale, exhale, we come back into that straddle pose. Feet are parallel, halfway lift, lengthen the spine, take an inhale, exhale, fold, relax the head. And then come on up to the tips of your fingers. If it's okay in your body, flatten that left hand onto the mat and reach the right arm up, twisting again, releasing stress, anxiety, just wringing it all out, right? Yogis say, clean your house. We're cleaning house here. Take one more inhale. And as you exhale, bring the right hand to the mat, lift the left arm, twisting, opening. You're doing really good. Just one more inhale. And as you exhale, bring your hands to the mat. Point the right toes to the front of your, the right side of your mat, and step the left foot forward. We got this. Inhale, rise. Hands touch overhead, third eye into your heart. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhale and a loud sigh. Mountain pose. Arms long at your sides. Palms of the hands face the front edge of your mat. Shoulders are soft. Core is engaged. Pick up your toes. Feel the four corners of your feet rooted firmly down into the mat. And then drop your toes. Open your eyes. Find one spot to rest your gaze. Bring your hands to your hips, and then lift the right knee, right? And with your left hand, grab your left knee, or if you're feeling flexible today, you could grab your foot, but it doesn't really matter. And then you go ahead and reach the right arm back, thumb up, pinky down. If you're feeling okay, go ahead, turn your gaze to the back. And if that's not for you today, that's fine, keep breathing. Take one last inhale here, and as you exhale, release it out. You can wiggle it out a little bit, root down into your feet, hands on your hips, and then we'll just switch sides, lift the left knee, right hand grabs the left foot, left arm reaches back. If you want, go ahead, try grabbing the foot, see how it feels. I bet you could do it, surprise yourself. Maybe you gaze to the back hand, maybe you don't. Can you stand a little taller? Can you breathe a little deeper? You're doing good. Take one more inhale. Exhale, release. Give it a little shake. And we're going to do that just one more time. So plant your roots, stand tall, hands to your hips. Lifting the right knee. Left hand grabs the knee or the foot. Right arm extends out. Standing tall, pressing that right shoulder back. Maybe the gaze turns to the back hand, maybe not. Breathe really deeply here. Take one last inhale, and as you exhale, release. Shake it out. Just one more time. Root down, stand tall, hands to your hips. Left knee bends, right hand grabs the knee, or maybe you choose the option of grabbing the foot, and maybe you don't. Reach the arm back. Maybe you turn your gaze to your back hand. Maybe you don't. Breath is calm here. You got this. Just one more inhale. And as you exhale, release. Excellent job. Shake it out. Swim your arms out and up. Swan dive, nose to knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Step it back, chaturanga dandasana, high to low push-up, up dog and down dog, walk it out. Drop to your knees, come on down to your forearms. We do our low planks, knees on or off the mat, it's all good. Palms flat or fingers interlaced, it's all good. Here we go, you ready? Calm breathing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. Drop your hips, flatten your feet, deep inhale. Come on up. Don't even think about it, just do it. Yes, you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Halfway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Drop it. Excellent. Inhale. One last time. Let's go. Come on up. You ready? Calm breathing. Gently softening your eyes and your jaw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Drop your hips, flatten your feet. Inhale. Exhale, take a nap. One ear to the mat, arms long, palms up. Pick up a shoulder, roll it down your back. Pick up the opposite shoulder, roll that down your back. Take a deep inhale and a loud sigh. If you'd like, go ahead, flip your head, other ear to the mat. Turn your chin to face the mat. Turn the palms of your hands down to face the mat. Lift your head, neck, and shoulders. Lift your legs. Toes can touch, your legs can be spread a little wider. Lift your arms. Rolling the shoulders down your back. Think about getting longer and longer here as you breathe. Take one last inhale. And as you exhale, release it down. And we'll do one more. Chin to the mat. Palms of the hands face down. Rolling up in the shoulders. Lifting the legs. Lifting the arms. If you'd like, interlace fingers, reach the knuckles towards your toes, get really long here, breathing calmly. One more deep inhale, exhale, release everything down. Bend your knees, start to windshield wiper your legs side to side, and let the legs go long, chin to the mat. Hands next to your shoulders, and just really slowly start to roll up until an upward facing dog, right? So just the hands and the tops of the feet on the mat, pressing the belly button forward, turning the gaze up, deep inhale, exhale, curl the toes, press back, down dog, walk it out. Drop to your knees. Cross your ankles and find a seat in the center of your mat. Sitting up really tall. Feet and hands are parallel. You slowly, slowly, slowly unroll. Setting up that mini shavasana. Eyes are closed. Arms long at your sides. Palms turn up. Deep inhale through your nose, fill your lungs all the way to the top, and hold your breath. Hold it. Let it go out your mouth. Deep exhale. Good. Now, with your eyes and lips closed, inhale slowly through your nose as I count for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause, hold your breath. And then slowly exhale. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause. Exhale slowly. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Repeat this a few more times on your own. Bend your knees, plant your feet on the mat. Feet are hip-width distance. Knees and ankles should be in one direct line. Pressing down into your feet, slowly lift the hips and roll up. You can keep the arms long at your sides or interlace the fingers, scooching the shoulders a little closer. Press down to lift up, keep breathing. Release your hands and slowly unroll one vertebrae at a time. Allow it to feel really good in your body. And we'll do it again. Slowly lift the hips, roll up one vertebrae at a time. Arms can stay long or you scooch the shoulders and interlace the fingers. If you want to lift the heels, you can. Stay connected to that calm, deep Ujjayi breathing. Release the hands. If the heels are lifted, keep them lifted and slowly unroll one vertebrae at a time. Take your time. There's no rush. Hips and then heels land. And we'll do it one more time. Roll up. Arms stay long or you scooch the shoulders and interlace the fingers. Heels stay flat or you lift them up. Maybe this time you lift the right leg, point the toes to the sky. Keep breathing. The right leg's lifted, return it to the mat. Lift the left leg. Keep breathing. Return that foot to the mat. Press down, lift up as high as you can. Take a great big inhale. And as you exhale, release the hands if they're interlaced. Slowly, slowly, slowly unroll. Hips and then heels. And if you'd like, you can widen your feet as wide as the mat and bring your knees together to touch. Or you come right into Supta Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet come together, one hand on your belly and one hand on your heart. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhale through your nose and a loud sigh out of your mouth. Feel the gentle rise and fall of your belly as you breathe. Feel the gentle rhythm of your heartbeat. Allowing your body to open and soften. When you're ready, gently open your eyes. Bring your knees together to touch and hug them into your chest. Then you can rock side to side and make little circles one direction and then the other. And then lift your legs up, heels press up to the ceiling. And reach your fingers up, see if you can touch your toes. And then arms come over your head, legs lower about 2 inches off the mat. And then lift and tap. That's one, two, three. If you'd like, you can bend your knees and touch your knees. Four, five, six, seven. Keep going, make sure you're breathing. Eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, keep going, yes you can, 14, 15, we're almost there, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, one more, 21, excellent, hug your knees into your chest, rock side to side, and make those little circles one direction and then the other. And then we're going to do scissor legs just to stretch out a little more. So lift the right leg up, grab the shin or the ankle, straighten the left leg, allow it to hover 2 inches off the mat. We switch sides, nose to the knee, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. That's it. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock side to side. And then we're going to rock and roll a couple times. Come on up to your hands and your feet, downward facing dog. Take a moment, walk it out. Feet come together to touch. Lift that right leg. Look at your hands. Step your right foot to the outside of your right hand. Drop your back knee to the mat, lengthen that back leg. Right toes point out to the right side of the room and flip the foot up. You can stay on long arms here, bending the back knee, finding the foot, pulling the heel gently in towards the glute as you twist open. You could just stay on long arms if you'd like. You could come on down to your forearms. And if you're on your forearms and you want to try grabbing that foot, feel free. Keep breathing here. You're free to linger here if this is working. When you're ready, release the foot, come to long arms. Point the right toes to the front of the mat and then press your hips back, toes towards your third eye as you fold forward. Always mindful breathing here, staying calm and connected. And then come forward, bend into that right knee, setting up half pigeon, your version, the yin or the yang version. Left leg gets long, arms are long. Lift your heart and gaze up here. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, come on down to your forearms. Resting the chin on your hands if you'd like. If you'd like to do that shoulder stretch, the right arm reaches under, or no, I'm sorry, the left arm reaches underneath your torso and you make a fist with your right hand. Take a moment or two and find that place that feels good. And then take a deep inhale and sigh, softening into it. Staying focused on your Ujjayi breathing, not allowing your thoughts to wander. Stay here in this moment. Stay on your mat, in your practice, in your mind and in your body. So if this is working for you and you want to stay, feel free to stay. When you're ready to come out of it, just come on up to long arms. Curl the back toes under, straighten the legs, step back, down dog, walk it out for a moment or two. Left leg lifts, three-legged dog, step the foot outside of the left hand, lengthen the back leg, drop the knee. Turn the toes out to a 45-degree angle, flip the foot up. Staying just like this on long arms if this works in your body. If you want, go ahead, bend the back knee, grab the foot, pull the heel in towards the glutes. Staying just like this, or maybe you come on down to your forearms. Maybe you are on your forearms and maybe you reach back and grab that foot, pull the heel gently in towards the glutes. Twisting, the gaze turns up. You knew we were going to do twisting lizard in the desert, right? How could we not? Keep breathing. As always, lingering, if this is what you need. When you're ready, release the foot. Point the left toes to the front of your mat and press the hips back. Toes point to your third eye, belly to your thigh, just a gentle stretch. And then you come forward, bend into that left knee, scooch the foot over to the right side, setting up your version, whatever that may be on this left side, of half pigeon. So you're free to stay on long arms. You could come on down to your forearms. And if you want to do that shoulder stretch on this side, it's the right arm that comes under this time. And you rest your forehead on the left hand, or not. Staying soft and connected. There's nothing for you to do in this moment but to breathe and to soften. This is working and it feels really delicious in your body. Stay. You're ready to come out. Come on up to long arms. Once again, lift your heart. Turn your gaze up to the sun. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, sit on that left hip and bring your right leg along to the front of your mat. Shake your legs out for a second. Lift your arms up to the ceiling. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, fold forward, grabbing whatever you can. Maybe you can scoot your hips back a little bit. Belly is fully pulled in, core engaged. Forehead lengthening, reaching towards your toes. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, you soften. You notice you go deeper the more you soften and relax. Do it again, forehead to the toes. Inhale. Exhale, let it drop. One more time. Inhale. Hold here. And slowly start to lift up. If you need to bend your knees to grab your toes, feel free to go ahead. And your right hand's going to grab your left foot, and you're going to reach that left arm back as you lift the left leg up. Right? So just like we did as we were standing, same thing here. Maybe the gaze turns to the back thumb. Maybe you lift the leg a little bit higher. Can you sit taller? Can you breathe deeper? Take one last inhale. Sit up as tall as you can. Exhale, release. center left hand, right foot, reach it back as you lift the leg high, get tall, breathe. Shake the legs out. Hands come a few inches beyond your hips. Fingers point towards your toes. Bend your knees. Plant your feet on the mat. Feet are hip-width distance apart for our tabletop. Lift it up. Drop the head. Breathing here. You got this. Root into your hands. Root into your feet. Lift a little higher. And as you exhale, drop your hips to the mat. Legs are long, toes touch and point. Sit on your fingertips. Roll it back onto your elbows, fish pose. Opening our hearts, allowing our necks to be open and exposed here. Unless you have a sensitive neck, it's completely acceptable to keep the head lifted. Otherwise, you drop it. We do lion's breath here. Take a deep inhale. Stick out your tongue. Again. Last one. Excellent job. Release your hands. Release your elbows. Lay flat down on your back. Bring your arms out like a T. Bend your knees. Plant your feet on the mat. Widen your feet. Feet are as wide as the mat. And just let your knees windshield wiper side to side. Just a couple more times. And the next time the knees come over to the right, allow them to land. Just rest there. If it feels okay, you can place the right foot on the left knee. Turn your gaze to the left. Staying calm. Palms are faced up. Lift the left arm, reach across, hands touch. Glide the left arm over your chest and back. If that felt good, do it one more time. Lengthen, stretch, and then gracefully glide it back, opening up. And then release that foot from your knee, windshield wiper your legs side to side. This should feel really good on your low back and your hips. The next time your knees come to the left, allow them to rest there. Left foot, right knee. Gaze to the right, knees to the left. Calm breathing as you allow your shoulders to fall deeper into the earth. When you're ready, lift the right arm, come across, hands touch, and then glide it back, opening up. If that felt good, do it one more time. And then remove the foot from the knee. Bring the thighs together to touch. Hug your knees into your chest and rock side to side. Make little circles one direction and then the other. And then hug your knees in tight to your chest. Moment of gratitude. Think of one thing that you're deeply grateful for in this moment. Take a deep inhale. And as you sigh, set up Shavasana. If you'd like to cover your eyes with something, feel free to go ahead, grab a shirt, a towel, anything you have handy. Rock your head side to side. Scoot your hips, find a space that feels really comfortable. Arms long at your sides, palms open. Take a deep inhale through your nose, fill your lungs, and hold your breath. Hold it at the top. your mouth. Allowing your body, your muscles and your bones to sink and grow so heavy on the mat that it feels as if you're floating. Bring your awareness to your toes, the balls of your feet, your arches and your heels, and all those tiny bones in your feet. Feel them soften and relax. Excuse me. Your ankles are relaxed. Your shins and your calves soften and sink. Your knees are relaxed. Your thighs and your thigh bones melt. Feel your hips, glutes, pelvis, all of your internal organs melt into the mat. Feel your entire spinal column slowly, one vertebrae at a time, sink into the mat. Your shoulders and your angel bones relax. Your ribs and your lungs relax. Your heart quietly, gently beats in your chest. All of the muscles in your back melt. Biceps, triceps, elbows, forearms, wrists, all 10 fingers. Those tiny bones in your hands, even your fingernails relax. Your neck is relaxed. Your chin, jaw, teeth, tongue, lips, relax. Ears, cheeks, and nose, relax. Eyes, eyeballs, eyelids, and eyebrows, relax. Forehead, scalp, and brain. Your entire body is relaxed. I welcome you to stay for a few more moments, longer if you can, right here in Shavasana. natured by the rays of the sun, be healed by the light of the moon. Love places that make you realize how tiny you and your problems are. When you feel ready, you can start to reach your arms over your head, straighten your legs, point your toes, and stretch out. You could hug your knees into your chest and roll over to a side. And there's no rush. When you feel ready, just gently come on up to a seat. Bring your hands to your heart. And we end the session with the sound of unity. One long om. Take a deep inhale. Bring your thumbs to your forehead. The light and truth in me honors and sees the light and truth in you. Namaste. Thank you once again for joining me at the Black Rock Desert in Nevada for Yoga on the Road with Melissa. If you'd like the session and you want to stay connected, so don't forget to hit subscribe. Feel free to leave any comments or suggestions. I'm always open to anything that you'd like to work on. I'll see you next time. Namaste.